Greetings, fellow nerds. Time to make another simple battery. Today will be the aluminum air battery with household materials. We start with about 60 grams of table salt and add in 300 milliliters of water. Stir it up until most of it dissolves. If it doesn't completely dissolve, that's fine. Now we get ourselves a couple of square feet of aluminum foil. This will serve as our anode or negative electrode. Bunch it up into a ball, but don't pack it too tightly yet. Now get a needle or sharp rod and poke holes through it. The idea is that we don't want to trap air when we put it into the salt water. Set that aside, and now get some steel wool. Fluff it off a bit so it's slightly larger than the mouth of the container you're using. This will serve as our cathode or positive electrode. Now get some wires with alligator clips and attach them to each electrode material. Now stuff the aluminum into the bottom of the salt water and pack it down. Next, get a paper towel and lay it over the aluminum. This will serve as a separator between the electrodes. Make sure that the aluminum is completely covered, as well as the metal part of the alligator clip. Now stuff the steel wool on top. And that is a simple aluminum air battery. What's happening is that the iron catalyzes the reaction of oxygen with water to make hydroxide, while the aluminum reacts with the hydroxide to form aluminum oxide. Overall, the reactants are the aluminum metal and the oxygen in the air. So let's check its output with this multimeter. Connected up to the clips, we can see the voltage is around 0.23 volts, give or take. The current is pretty low at less than 20 milliamps. This is because we're using a crude homemade setup. A more advanced cell uses aluminum metal alloys and better chemicals for more voltage and current. But you can see the basic chemistry here. In an upcoming video, I am going to make a much better zinc air battery. So please subscribe.